Wow, how delicious the food is. I wonder what this food is made up of. Ouch! Have you wondered what the universe is made up of? Like this dish, our universe also should be made up of something, right? So, what are the ingredients that make up our universe?
Water. Earth. Fire. Air.
In the old days, people used to think that everything is made up of these four elements. But now, we know that all things are made up of atoms. And everything else can be understood in terms of jigglings and wigglings of atoms. Even rock, water, air and fire is made up of atoms. The most remarkable discovery of astronomy is that stars is made up of atoms. Of the same kind that are present on the Earth. But here's the twist. All the matter that we know and see accounts only for 15% of the universe. Remaining 85% of the universe is made up of dark matter. Not dark chocolate. The universe can't be delicious for my sake. So what is dark matter? How do we know it really exists? What I do with it? And why should we care about it? Let's go one by one. What is dark matter? Here you can see all these things because they are interacting with light. But in case of dark matter, we call it dark because it doesn't interact with light. That is, it doesn't absorb or emit or reflect light. That's why we can't see them. They are invisible.
Come out, you wimp! Don't hide! Show your true identity! Come out!
If a dark matter is present between a light source and your eyesight, you can still see the light source because dark matter doesn't block any light, but still it could be there.
We call it matter because it has mass. Anything that has mass can feel gravity. Gravity is basically the attraction between two masses. That's why when you jump, you come back down because Earth is attracting, pulling you down. Dark matter doesn't interact with regular matter. That's why you can't touch or else taste dark matter, which means dark matter is not made up of atoms or any known particles.
How do we know dark matter really exists?
Dark matter interacts with ordinary matter only via gravity. Consider the scenario. When I rotate this ball slowly, I can hold it normally. But when I rotate it faster, I should hold it tightly or else it will fly away.
When I rotate slowly, the sticky notes won't fly away. But when I rotate quickly, the sticky notes will fly away.
From the rotation of stars in galaxies, we find that the stars are moving faster than what they should. But they're not flying away too. So something is holding the stars together. The calculation of mass from what we see and the mass from how fast the objects are moving should be equal. But we observe that the dynamical mass is 5 times more than the luminous mass. So something invisible is hiding and holding the stars together. We know that if there is more gravitational attraction, there is more mass. This extra invisible matter is 5 times more than the ordinary matter, which means 85% of the universe is made up of something invisible and mysterious that's holding the stars and galaxies together. And that is love. Just kidding, that's dark matter.
What do we do with dark matter? Think of all the food that you love but don't know how to make it. For example, grandma's secret recipe, mom's special dish, or else Domino's pizza. You may know the general recipe of making this dish, but how hard you try, it's difficult to replicate the exact dish unless you know the exact recipe and the secret ingredient, which may be the reason for the taste of the dish. Likewise, there are some astronomical phenomena for which we don't know how the end products are formed. In my research, I try to solve these problems by adding the secret ingredient, dark matter, in different ratios until I arrive at the desired end product.
Why should we care about dark matter? Why? Imagine our big purple friend Thanos. Instead of wiping off of the population of the universe, this time he plans to wipe out 85% of the universe. That is, he wipes out entire dark matter. Imagine what will happen. It will be a total mess. The stars in the galaxies will fly apart, and the galaxies in the galaxy clusters will be torn apart. The universe will be chaotic. Imagine, all of a sudden, there is no cement in the building in which you are right now. If there is no cement in the structure, what will happen? The structure will collapse. Like cement, dark matter is a binding material. Except that dark matter binds things gravitationally, cement binds things chemically. That's why it is important to understand dark matter. If you don't believe in Thanos, you still might be wondering why I should be caring about dark matter. Here's why. From rubbing stones to create fire, to smashing atoms in the Large Hadron Collider, we humans are inventors. From looking deep down into the atoms using tunneling microscope, to the farthest galaxies using telescopes, we humans are explorers. From building computers to space stations, we humans are creators. We humans have accomplished all this by understanding just 15% of the universe. Imagine what if we uncover the rest. Thank you.
Oops, I forgot to tell about this one. Dark matter is everywhere. It's even passing through you right now. Since dark matter doesn't interact with normal matter, you can't feel it.